We have with us right now Mr. Hiren Gada, who is the director and CFO at Shemaroo Entertainment. Mr. Hiren, thank you very much for being with us here on NDTV Profit. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. Can you talk to us about the quarter overall, strong performance on the bottom line?
So, we're happy to report a fairly good quarter gone by March 31st, 2016, as well as the financial year 15-16. So, for the quarter, the top line has grown by 18.4%, and bottom line has increased by 28.8% to 16.45 crores. Versus for the full year, the top line has grown by 16% to 376 crores with a corresponding 27.4% increase in bottom line to 52 crores. So, and internals in terms of breakup on the income revenue has basically shows that new media business has grown 54% for the quarter and 70% for the full year. So that kind of is leading the overall growth as well as the growth in margins.
Right. When you talk about margins, what were the margins in Q4 and how do they compare with the previous year?
So basically the EBITDA margin for the quarter has grown by grown to 34% from 30.9%. So almost almost 400 basis points. And versus for the full year, it has grown by about 240 basis points actually, from 27.2% to 29.6%. I think, I mean, it has been a positive surprise in terms of margin growth even for us. So we are hoping that we can maintain this margin going forward, and that will definitely will be one of the efforts that we will be working towards.
And what led to this strong improvement in your EBITDA margin? Is that the higher contribution from your digital business?
Definitely, that has been one of the factors, which is higher contribution from the digital business, because till last year, we were kind of coming off from a low base, and for last almost more than 4 years, we've been growing at a more than 50% CAGR. But till last year, the base was still low. But this year, actually, the top line has grown 70% on a much higher base, and obviously, costs have not grown commensurate to that. So that's been one important contributor. And overall, we've seen better realizations even from the other sources or other streams in terms of pricing versus cost. So definitely that has been a positive surprise for us also.
Earlier we understand that the contribution of your digital business was in the single digits till about last year. Where does it stand right now?
Total contribution from digital space for the entire financial year FY16 is at about 17.5%, close to 18. And so if I see 2 years back, we were at probably sub 10%, maybe around close to 9%, which has now more than doubled in 2 years. And given the way, the pace at which it is, continuing, and what we are seeing even in terms of the industry projections by various, agencies, the new media business is projected to grow at around 30-35% as an industry level. So we hope that we should grow better than that. And therefore, it will continue to have a higher share in terms of the overall revenue mix.
Any number in terms of your contribution that you're likely to see from the digital space and new media going ahead that you can give us?
Well, it's very difficult to, and in fact, we do not give any forward guidance. But if I take a bigger picture, you know, meaning maybe a larger view, I think the way at which the way the pace at which handset penetration is growing, the pace at which the infrastructure, you know, 3G penetration, etc., has been growing, and we are awaiting the launch of a large 4G deployment, which is the Reliance Jio. You know, so hopefully with all of that, the momentum on the new media business should, you know, continue for the foreseeable future. So that, if you ask me, is the, you know, trend that the industry is seeing overall.
Right. You mentioned that, you know, the industry is, of course, waiting for the launch of 4G from Reliance Jio. Any sort of a tie-up that you are probably considering with Reliance Jio?
So, you know, we are in talks with different people, and it's very difficult to comment on any individual negotiation that may be going on. But given the large content library that we control, or we have, you know, we have been an you know, important content partner for most of the digital media deployments or services that are there. I mean, so YouTube, for example, you know, we are among the top channel partners in India, and in fact, our flagship channel, you know, Shemaroo, has in this quarter crossed a cumulative views of 1 billion views from day one. And even our overall views, so we did about 115 million views in the month of March, which is virtually more than 3.5 million views on a daily basis. So I think, you know, that continues overall. We've announced in this quarter a couple of tie-ups. So there's a video service pool with which we continue to have an ongoing relationship. So we've signed up for the content deal with them. We've launched two services on the TataSat DTH platform, which is Active Devotion, which was launched in February, and TataSat Comedy, which was launched in March. So we continue to explore, you know, all the various platforms. And as I said, you know, our model is essentially around aggregation and distribution. So we always are, you know, keen to work with all the any new platform that may be coming up.
And any update on the tie-up with Netflix? Is that expected anytime soon?
So, as I said, it's very difficult to talk on any individual negotiation that we may be having with anyone. But, you know, again, to reiterate, so India is overall a highly local ecosystem. So the content consumption pattern of the Indian audiences is highly localized. And therefore, for any service to have a meaningful presence in India, you know, you need to have a base local content presence. And, you know, to that extent, as I said, so, you know, we have a presence on, say, iTunes. Earlier we've announced tie-up with Hoo, you know, and so on and so forth. So, you know, virtually all the major digital platforms today we are working with, or in, you know, different stages of conversation.
Right. Can you share some details in terms of the debt that you have right now, and what are the plans on that front?
No, in fact, we've not cut it down. Rather, you know, the debt. So I think overall, we continue to be in an investment mode. So considering that, I think the debt levels definitely are not slated to come down in the immediate future. In fact, you know, we've discussed this earlier on different forums that for the next 2 years, given the opportunities that are there in front of us, we will continue to remain in an investment mode. And to that extent, it will be funded with a combination of internal accruals and debt. So overall, we will look to maintain a debt equity ratio roughly in the range of around, so we are comfortable to go up to 0.9 or even 1:1 debt equity ratio. And to that extent, I think, the debt for the next 2 years is likely to remain, is likely to continue and rather grow.
Right. And if you said, like you mentioned, that you are in an investment mode right now, what is the number that we are looking forward to in terms of investment that you will be making in FY17?
Partly it is a little deal specific, but if I look at the way we are looking at things, and based on our current operating plans, over the next two financial years, we expect to invest roughly about 150 crores in the further in the content net additional. So we do, there's a churn that keeps happening, but additional capital to be invested is expected to be roughly about 150 crores.